Hey, and welcome to Channel Ship at Hala. Today I'm playing in a standard daily event with Jund. This decklist was a recent 4-0 by Soku, and I went ahead and didn't change anything because I am not that proficient with Jund, though there are certainly things that I would like to change. There always are. I think the mana base is fine. I'm just going to go over briefly the things I would change, because really, I'm sure you've seen this deck before. The deck lists are pretty similar throughout, so I think the mana base is fine. Tragic Slip, all the removal is actually fine also. And I'm fond of Ground Seal, because it's really important for the Junk Reanimator matchup, and otherwise it's kind of just a free roll. Let's see. Key Rune, I'm not completely sold on. It's a maybe. I'm not a huge fan of having two Reactors Return and two Sires in this format, where Red-Green Aggro is the essentially the deck to beat. I guess I do want to change that. Everything else is pretty fine, so really most of the deck is fine. And then for the sideboard, though, I am kind of also on the fence. Deadbridge Chant, how I feel about this card, some of you may already know from my article a few weeks back. 6 mana, do nothing, and then you get to untap, probably do nothing again, and then next turn, maybe do something. It doesn't seem like a very good card. Obviously it's for a really long game, so it does have its purpose, and Staff of Nin would definitely get the slot, but Putrefy, like, the card is mostly for Jundmere matches, and Putrefy is a card now, so Staff of Nin's not quite as good. Gaze of Granite is pretty interesting, definitely has its uses. One Unrolled Connections is a good number of that card, so actually the sideboard I'm most okay with too, turns out. I think this deck is actually really good. I've played it a few times already, which is why I'm playing it today. I think it's really strong. So we're going to get started with round one in just a second. Alright, this is round one, for which we're on the draw. Okay. So this hand, I really hate this hand. Against an aggro deck, we have no play till turn four. Sire's basically dead. But the hand is kind of like, it has gas and lands to cast pretty much anything. So it's really hard to mulligan this. On the play, this would be much easier. On the draw, I'm going to have to keep it and just hope he's not aggressive, I think. And if he is, then I guess we have to hope that we draw Farseek or something like that. You know, we have a lot of 2 mana spells. Oh, well, that's too bad. Yeah, Farseek. Okay, there's Farseek. Alright, we're just... like, that changes this game so much dramatically. Turn 3 Huntmaster, turn 4 Thragtusk. Although, we're still, like, kind of... this Noble's really good right now. Second Noble. The second one... the third one... Maelstrom Pulse, anybody? Okay, that could be a little more of a challenge. Let's see, so we want a green mana. We want green and red. The deck really doesn't play that many black cards, main deck. And it plays Mizzy Mortars and Garruk, so... only after board do you ever really care that much about your additional black sources. You know, for Nighthawk and Underworld Connections. So, let's see. We can't even block with the Huntmaster. And he's probably going to burn the token. So we're in a lot of trouble. I don't know if Huntmaster into Thragtusk is actually going to be enough to get us out of this. Well, now it's definitely not. We don't really have another option, though. We can still put the Huntmaster in front of the Fire Fist Striker. That's kind of what we have to hope for. And then we have to hope, I think, that we draw Mizzy Mortars. Okay, yep. That's pretty much the worst thing. His draw was very good. I mean, his draw, this deck is really powerful. His draw definitely could have been even better with Birdie Tree Emissary, but we even drew that Farseek and didn't really stand a chance. If we were on the play, obviously it would be a lot different. Still could have lost, actually. So, yes, I don't think we have any chance of surviving. I just, why not try to play it out? Yeah, I could go to 5 if I chump block, and then I draw Mizzy Mortars. So yeah, actually, like, that's kind of an out if he also has nothing, which is unlikely because he didn't play a land last turn. Oh, you pillared my wolf. Alright, so now we could still draw, or we're going to be at 1, we could still draw Mortars and then have Thragtusk to block the Noble. Okay. Pretty good draw from him. Okay, the boarding for this matchup is pretty easy. Most matchups, I'd say, aren't that easy, because you have a lot of different cards. But we bring in all the removal and the Nighthawks, and potentially a Gaze of Granite, and then the cards we cut are really obvious too. Two more cards. Yeah, I'd much rather have Gaze than a Garruk, I think. Yeah, as made evidence by that game. I guess we could have drawn Bonfire in it, or the Mizzy Mortars in that situation. Always Bonfire. Okay, yeah, this looks pretty good.